This video is designed to explain and demonstrate reporting your public water system metric report for non-community water systems. If you have any questions or problems with logging in, you want to contact Sean Stevenson or Brian Tarver at the drop portal email address or phone number. Close that. So right here, we're on the customer service center main page. You're going to log in. And log into your account. If it takes you to your account settings where it's just displaying your name and address, you'll want to update that and select the account link on the top right. This account link will bring you to the page we're on now. And it has a list of all the water systems you're associated with. You're going to want to come in here and select the revise link on the right. You don't want to select the metrics application name. You want to go to the revise link. And this is your landing page for the beginning of the application. This has basic instructions on how to navigate this application itself. That there'll be a back button if you need to go to the previous page, and a next save progress button to go to the next page. And you want to make sure at the very end you get to the submit final form button. I'm going to click next. And it has my contact information that we know already. I want to correct anything that is not correct on there. Make sure we have a phone number and address for you. And click next. This question is for PWS information. Was the PWS operated? Did the public water system operate for any part of 2020, and or were you the owner and operator responsible in 2020? Most of you all are in here because you do need to report last year's metrics. Occasionally, we will have somebody that maybe just purchased it and didn't have any information on what happens last year. So I'm going to select yes, it was operating last year. And here I'm going to verify that I have reviewed and understand the metrics rule. And I'm going to select next. And this is the first question for our non-community metrics. Is the number of events the water system pressure was less than 20 PSI? And I'm going to put, and that to determine whether this is an actual or an estimate. If I need more information, there's a link here. This more information will bring you to the fact sheet for non-community water system, non-community metrics. So I'm going to select two and next. The total number of emergency repair, rehabilitation, or replacement tasks. So this is any emergencies I had over 2020. Let me say I had four, and that was an actual. And down below here, I can write any kind of comments I need to that I think may be appropriate here. You do not have to put any content, any content, yeah, comments. And select next. And this is the number of planned repairs, rehabilitation, or replacement tasks I had last year. So I had planned on going in, and that's an actual. And then I select next. And total reserve funds. This is the amount of reserve funds on hand or available for immediate use by the water system. And the comment here is recommended that you have enough on hand to replace the most critical water system asset in the event of failure. If no funds are set aside, I can report zero. I'm going to report 5,000. And they say that's an estimate. And select next. Number of days unable to serve water. And that's total number of days you're unable to serve water. And this includes any portion of the day that you are unable to serve. So I'm going to put that it was 4 days that I think I wasn't able to serve, or four portions of days. So I'm going to put that in and hit next. And that was all my metrics questions. Now I just have to certify that that this is true to the best of my knowledge. I've reviewed the contingency plan rules, and these metrics are true and accurate to the best of my knowledge. So I'm going to certify that, yes, I am authorized to submit this, and that I am willing to sign this electronically. And I'm going to come down here with my mouse and try to write my name. And again, my name down here. And put my title. And hit next. And this will let me review what I have submitted. So if I look at this, open this link. Click that. Say open. Wow. And this is going to come up. This is a note. This is created prior to submission. This is a draft version of what I'm going to submit. It just lets me review the, you know, here's the information I had in there. I selected yes, metrics were required. And here's a list of the answers I gave. So I can review those. Scroll down and my signature page. I'm going to minimize that. That's just a draft copy. I'm going to check that I have reviewed that draft copy and click next. And this is the submit page. This is the last page, next to the last page. If everything was correct on that draft application, I'm going to hit submit. If it wasn't, I can go back. Use the back button to go to any section that I needed to update again. So if I come back, say something wasn't correct, I come back and go, oh, I have $5,500. And when I make a change, I want to make sure I hit next so that it will save my change. And then I can go back up to my review and submit. I can re-review that draft copy if I need to. And since everything is correct, I'm going to submit the final form. Once it's submitted, it's going to lock the application. So you cannot go back and make any changes once you've submitted. I'm going to hit submit, and it's going to bring me to a confirmation page. I will have a confirmation number up here, which will also be on the final submission form. Gives me a couple of phone numbers I can use to contact us and email. And here's the final copy of that application. It's going to be very similar to what we looked at as a draft. Open it. Except now, instead of it saying it was a preliminary application, it does have my reference number and when I submitted it on it. And you may want to save or even print this so you have a copy for your records. And at that point, you are done with submitting your non-community metric application for 2020.